super producer, writer, and director Steven Spielberg is back with his new epic movie, Bridge of Spies. And we're going to talk about this movie right now. See you on the other side. Hello, welcome back to Showtime. And today we're going to talk about the new epic movie from Steven Spielberg. Now, I've always been impressed by the creativity and unique way that Steven Spielberg works. And you got his great movies like War Horse, E.T., Saving Private Ryan, and so many other movies that I can't list them all. There's so many great movies that he's touched with his creative hands. And this movie, Bridge of Spies, it starts off in 1957 to the 1960s. And it's going to be some spoilers, so you've been warned. And it starts off with this guy called Rudolph. And he receives a secret message in a park in Brooklyn. And his apartment gets raided by the FBI, the CIA, and he gets prosecuted for espionage, spying against the US, against America. And the character played by Tom Hanks, James Donovan, is an attorney, a lawyer, and he has to defend this Rudolph character. Meanwhile, there's this mission, secret mission by the CIA, and there's this U-2 spy plane flying over the Soviet Union, and it gets shot down and the pilot gets captured, and there has to be an exchange. The movie moves on, and at the end of the day there has to be an exchange from the KGB spy in America and the down U-2 pilot in the Soviet Union. So they want to exchange each of the captured spies. So that's more or less the plot, just the exchange. And towards the end of the movie, you understand why it's called Bridge of Spies. I didn't particularly like this movie. I felt that it had pacing issues and it came off very boring. I found it very boring. And it's not because, for me personally, to enjoy a movie, I need explosions and great visual effects. It's not because of that. It's just the way it was executed. And it's very disappointing because I really like Steven Spielberg. He's proven over and over again, he's a master. He knows his job. He knows how to use a camera. He knows how to create suspense. So it was disappointing to watch this movie. So I love war movies. One of my favorite movies is Unbroken and Black Hawk Down. So I was expecting something much better. I was expecting to be entertained. This kind of movie, I don't believe is the type of movie that should be in a cinema. It should be streamed, maybe on Amazon Prime or Netflix. That would be the right home for Bridge of Spies. And even to take it to the next level, I believe this movie would be much better in a season of maybe 13 episodes, just to space it out a bit. But it seemed rushed and slow. If you watch this movie, now, for those of you out there that are history buffs, that love history, you're gonna really enjoy this movie. And I love watching true life movies that are based on true events that actually happened. I love them. And yes, I love Star Wars. I love Battlestar Galactica. I do love action movies, but I do love well-written dramas also. I really do. But it was just the pacing issues with this movie. I just found it boring. And this is just my personal opinion of this movie. Maybe there's you guys out there that probably love this type of movie in the cinema. But when I go to the cinema, I want to be entertained. That's the whole reason why I'm paying for that cinema ticket, to be really entertained. So I'm going to give Bridge of Spies a 3 out of 10. And my only wish concerning this project is that Steven Spielberg makes Bridge of Spies as a TV show. I think there will be a lot more success, and it would eliminate the pacing issues with this project and this story. Because it is a good story, but it deserves to be executed and delivered in a different manner. So guys, thank you so much for tuning in, and there'll be some new reviews coming very, very, very soon. So if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up down below, subscribe to Showtime, and see you very, very soon. Bye-bye.